Hello my dear students, today we are going to do a topic on the writing skill, that is summary writing. I am referring to page 136 of the textbook. So now let us try to understand and try to know a few tricks of how to write a good summary. So let's begin. Brevity is the soul of wit is one of the countless maxims coined by William Shakespeare. What does this mean? It means that an intelligent writing or a speech should aim at using few words. You know, it's very necessary that at times we need not write into pages, maybe 200, 300, 400 words. We have to have the ability of writing it as short as possible. Now, this is something which this is a very famous proverb, a maxim. Which comes from the play Hamlet, written by William Shakespeare. Now, why this is important? He says brevity or concision is cutting out unnecessary words while conveying an idea. So, you are going to make it as short as possible. The message should be conveyed. That is what is important. Okay. So, we are eliminating redundancy. Redundant meaning. That you are exceeding, you are cutting out all the exceeding words and trying to be in the normal limit. Okay, now summary writing is being described as one of the elementary stages of writing, is one of the important and first stages of writing. Okay, so if you know to expand, you should also have the ability to express it as in a limited version as possible. Okay, to speak what is required and to write what is necessary is a requisite, is a requirement of development of language skills. To express in brief, we are writing it in brief as possible, the written record. So, it is a written record. And this is a skill which comes only by practice. You have to constantly keep writing. You know, take some passage and start practicing, find out the important ideas and just start writing. So, it requires a good practice. And what is the purpose of a summary? Summary is to give the reader a clear and an objective picture. See, a novel, for example, would run into 200, 300 pages. But if you want to know in brief what is the theme of the novel, you can always see at the back. It will be written in very short. If it's in 300 words, it will come to 25, 30 or 50 words maximum. Okay, so it gives only the main idea or the main points of the text or a lecture for that matter. And we are excluding all the details like dates, numbers, statistics. Why are we excluding? If we include all this, then your summary gets even longer. So, our purpose is to write it as short as possible. Now, here are a few things that you need to remember while you are writing your summary. So, whenever you are given a piece of writing, first you have to read it once. When you read it once, maybe some ideas are clear. When you have a second reading of it, some more ideas become clear. So, you have to read and reread it. You have to understand what is the theme of the passage. Read the instructions and then you have to find out what you have to summarize. Identify the main ideas. What are the main ideas, meaning the main points coming in? And this you can come up with by asking questions. Now, what questions? Questions of what, when, where, why, how. All these questions, if you ask, you are going to get the answer for it. And then, once you are done with the main idea, what you are going to do is, you are going to write it in your own words, as short as possible. Then, you are going to connect them with linkers. Linkers meaning, how you are going to connect one statement with another statement. Okay, you try to develop a relationship between the two ideas. That's by the use of, you know, in the meanwhile, in the end, since, so, further, in addition to. You know, these are the linkers. And remove redundant words. Whatever words are unnecessary, explanations need not include that. Omit the details, extra details which are given. and avoid your own interpretation. No need of writing, I think so, in my opinion. No, you are not asked your opinion. You are supposed to write whatever is expressed in the passage. Now, there are some don'ts. As you know, the do's of the writing, summary writing, you have to keep in mind certain don'ts, which we tend to forget. Okay, so include, don't include, don't exclude. Include meaning don't include your own ideas. Exclude meaning don't exclude whatever is necessary, write those. Don't add up stuffs. We don't need extra information. You might have some extra information on the topic, so you need not that. You need not comment that this is right, this is wrong, according to me, no. And don't give further examples. Even if those examples have been cited in the text or the passage, you are supposed to omit all that. Okay. One important point is also add up a title which is not mentioned here. Don't forget to give a title to your passage, to your summary. And the summary should be one paragraph, only one paragraph. Do not make the mistake of writing into 2-3 paragraphs. So you have to be as concise as writing maximum, I would say, 5-6 sentences, and with a good title. All right. To make you understand how we are supposed to write the summary, an example is being given in the text, which is all about learning disability. Okay, learning disability is an umbrella term for a variety of learning problems. Okay, there are children who face a lot of problems in studying. Some are good, some are meticulous, okay, and some are average, and then some are below average. Okay, so some children face problems in reading, writing, understanding. Okay, so they might be real slow in grasping the content, whatever is taught in the school. Okay, so we need to observe. The parents need to observe. Moreover, the teachers at the lower level should understand that this particular child is facing some kind of a problem, and is because he is not able to learn or to function accordingly, according to the age. Because you will find that such children are little different from others in matters of learning and understanding and in various ways. And what are the problems that they come up with is they face problems in reading, writing, speaking, reasoning, dealing with maths. So a teacher is the best person to, you know, identify such problems. And one can understand that these children are facing learning, they are having some learning disorders. Okay, and now they have cited a few disorders like dyslexia, dysgraphia, dyscalculia. And there are some specific reading disability. There's auditory processing disorder, APD, ADHD. That's auditory processing disorder, known as the central auditory processing disorder. So that affects the brain that travels unimpeded through the ear. Unimpeded meaning it comes unobstructed. Okay. Individuals with APD do not recognize subtle differences between whether it's a sound, it's a word. These children are not able to understand. Then they have tried to explain the different problems, okay, the different disorders. The dyscalculia is the child who is facing problems with doing maths, okay, he is not able to understand the numbers. Then dysgraphia is whatever is written on the board, the child cannot understand. For B, he might read it as P. Okay. D also, he might write it as P. So, there is problem with reading, fluency, decoding, trying to understand, trying to recall. You make them understand 10 times and they might forget it. Okay. So, all these, you know, sometimes all these listening, speaking, reading, writing, they overlap. They come over one over other. The brain is not able to differentiate between that. That's the problem over there. Okay, so any one problem, if the child is facing problem in seeing, okay, or he is having problem in hearing, the other areas also might get affected. If he cannot hear properly, he cannot speak, the speech is affected. Because he cannot hear, he cannot read and write properly. So all these problems are associated or linked with each other. And then that develops as a great problem, because they cannot pay attention, they get very restless and hyper, and it sometimes becomes very difficult to control their behavior. Okay, so such kind of problems are usually identified in classrooms, and they are resolved. So it's not that there is no solution or a treatment for this. You have got special schools to deal with such kind of a children who are facing such disorders, and which you have the various teaching methodologies and conducive environment. You know, an environment is made whereby the child doesn't feel frightened, okay, because but then what this is, it's always better to have inclusive classrooms. Whereby, what are inclusive classrooms? Inclusive classrooms are whereby you are not separating children with the learning disorders from the normal children. They are allowed to learn along with them, because the more you interact, the more they develop. Okay, their speech improves. So that's the way all children are treated equally, irrespective of the challenges that they are facing. But then he says our country is facing such a problem where inclusive learning is not given much of an importance. Okay, so we need to have this for which the parents, teachers, the institutions, they should come forward and help these children overcome these problems, because they need to be handled. It's at the lower stage that they need to be handled with care, and they need the love, the encouragement, the support. So they can come, if they have some speech like stammering or something, that can be overcome with special care taken over. Okay, so they can emerge as self-confident, self-worth, they come to know their self-worth, and they become even more determined. Okay, so we should try to help such kind of children. So this was all about this article was all about the learning disorders of children. So this particular article has to be converted into a small article, which is like 5 to 6 or maximum 7-8 sentences, depending on the length of your article. So in your exam you will be provided clues. So you don't forget to give a title to it. Read it twice. As I said, read it twice so that you get a better understanding. You ask questions so that you can find out the main ideas of it. You can write it a rough draft and then read it over, edit, and then you can write on the final draft. So that's how they have come up with a smaller, concise version of the article on learning disability. So firstly, what they have said is learning disability has, you know, it's a one term which includes children with so many problems, and then it can be rectified, they say, if it is identified at an earlier stage. Then they talk about the different disorders, all right, and they say do not separate the problem. This problem can be sorted out easily by involving them, by the way of inclusion, they say. And last and importantly is such children need a lot of care and support so that they can overcome these challenges. They no longer, you know, dependent on others, but then they should be taught to be independent, become self-confident and more determined. So I hope you have understood this. Thank you.